I knew a guy once, knew this girl, and he said his wife divorced her, and I can see why.
Did she just push you on the floor or what, sir?
She's weird like that.
Sit up there, please. And what were you doing on the floor there, sir?
I have pretty much no idea.
Everybody sit up straight in your chairs. I turn my back on you people for a couple seconds and you start causing all kinds of problems. And you look like a nice lady. What were you doing on the floor?
I don't know.
Everybody sit up straight in your chairs. How many of you like music here? Everybody likes music? I've got a piece of music here. I think you're going to find quite enjoyable. Under absolutely no circumstance when you fall. Listen. Listen close. At the count of three, and only at the count of three, back to the theater, of course, watching one of the most romantic love stories you've ever seen in your entire lifetime. This movie is going to become so incredibly sad. You're going to do everything in your power to try to hold those tears back. But it's going to be impossible. They have to flow. Impossible to hold the tears back. Ladies, gentlemen, you don't care who's watching. You're in your cars anyway. Nobody can see. On the count of three. Watching one of the saddest movies you've ever experienced. One, two, three. Getting sadder. Sadder. At the count of three, this movie becomes so incredibly sad. Those tears are just going to have to burst loose. It'll be impossible to hold them, no matter how hard you try. One, two, three. Just comfort the person sitting next to you. Possibly, doesn't matter if it's a gentleman or a lady. Just let them know it's going to be okay. Just don't worry about it. Let's take a look at the screen. Take a look at the screen. God, look at that. Look at that. It's not so sad anymore. There's a bunch of kids on the street playing with their puppy. God. Wouldn't you love to have a puppy like that of your own someday? Yeah, what a cute little fella. God, I know if he was yours, he grew up with you, and he'd be your best friend. God, it's not so sad anymore. It's bringing so much happiness back to your heart, and your smile is coming across your face. Yeah. God, he's on the street playing with the kids. God, memories. Yeah, your own puppy, your own dog. God, what a lovely sight to see. Oh my God, he just got hit by a bus! Not the puppies, this roadkill! Victory on bus, oh my God. He got one of the kids, too, Grace, one of the kids, oh my God. Oh, look. Look at the screen. Look at the screen again. It wasn't a puppy after all. It was nothing else but a mangy old skunk. Oh, yeah. You feel so much better now. I'll live happily ever after. Move away to Tisdale. Why do you want to start the third movie, of course? Why do you want to start the third movie? But you happen to have in your lap there a bag of popcorn. Yes, that legendary popcorn at the movies. Yes, buttered popcorn. Just toss some of those kernels up in the air. Try to catch them with your mouth there, yeah. Try to be fancy. Everybody tries that, don't they? Yes. Oh, yeah. Wait for them to start the third movie. But you know the trouble with popcorn, don't you? You always get that stuff stuck in between your teeth. You always get that stuff stuck in your teeth. Yes. At the count of three, you're going to experience one of the most horrifying suspense thrillers you've ever seen in your entire lifetime. It's worse than Dracula's Castle. It's worse than Nightmare on Elm Street. It's worse than Michael Jackson being a father. But keep in mind, it's only a movie. One. Two. You're feeling the chills come up and down your spine, and the movie hasn't even started yet. You think something just grabbed your shoulder! The movie hasn't even started yet. Take a look at the screen. Take a look at the screen. She's in the shower. Where else would she be? The creature's coming down the hallway. It's about to tear her to pieces. Oh my God. Shit, the film broke. The film broke. Always buggers at the good time of the movie. Wait for them to fix the film. Wait for them to fix the film. Something very strange has happened. Take a look outside your car windows. It's pitch black. You must have fallen asleep during the movie. There's not another car in sight. Try to start the car to go home. Try to start the car to go home. Shit, it's a Ford. And there's something outside your car. Open the window. It's on the ground beside the car. Oh my God, there's an amputated hand leg there. And it's trying to get inside the car. It's in the backseat of the car. Everybody, wide awake, wide awake. What the hell are you people doing again? Get back in your seats right now. What are you running around for, huh?
Lost.
You're lost.
You bet.
Just behave yourselves, please. All of you, we're all adults here. Pardon?
And your point is?
I'm trying to do a show here, okay? And every time I turn my back, like you people, you start running around, crawling all over the damn floor.
It's the air.
Pardon?
It's the atmosphere.
What do you mean the atmosphere?
Atmosphere. Out here. Fumes coming from everywhere. The gas fumes from outside.
Gas fumes? Is that what's making you do it? Yeah. Pardon, sir?
I'm still thinking of Old Yeller.
Old Yeller? What about Old Yeller, sir?
You say he got hit by a bus. I know he got hit by a bus. He'd shoot him at the end.
What the hell are you talking about? We're here. You know what this guy's talking about? So we're here in a nightclub.
Ah, I have no clue what he's talking about.
Pardon, sir?
His parents had sex too close to the microwave.
You know, the fun thing about doing this show, this is working on my 20th year of performing as a stage hypnotist, and I never know what to expect. You never know what to expect out here because people's got so many different imaginations. Why, sir?
Ever wonder
about what, sir?
Come, I'm still better looking than him.
Sorry, sir, I don't know the mailman or the postman either, so. Hi, how you doing? Glad to meet you.
Sleep.
What, sir?
How do you do that, man?
You want ability to do it? Come over here. I'm going to transfer the power that I have from my body to yours. Hey, just move yourself over here a little bit. And just move over here. Face me. I want you to get yourself braced here because I'm going to give you a good stiff handshake, all right? What's going to happen? The power is going to leave the center of my body, down my arm, into my hand, into your hand, through your arm, the center of your chest. It's going to hit you like electricity. Won't physically hurt you, but you'll feel it. Energy leaving my body into yours. And then you'll have the capability to just walk up to anybody, shake their hand, and they bite the dust like that.
No way.
What? Let go, sir. Come over here. Your feet a little bit. So how's that feel? You like it? I've held that for 20 years, okay?
Make doing this.
Just shake anybody's hand. It doesn't matter who it is. Go ahead. Watch what happens to him. You got it. You got it now. Go ahead, quickly. Well, it's only one transfer. You can't keep transferring it. Nah, you got it now. That's it. You can go like this with your hand like that, and that'll work too. A high five, that'll work too. Yeah, we'll try it. Go ahead. Be careful, you don't want to use a lot of energy. So what do you think, eh? No, because I'm used to the energy. I'm immune to it. The system is immune to it. So what do you think about it?
Yeah, I gotta take it away from you, right?
Well, I want to tell you something. I've never given it to anybody for any length of time, so I don't know how it would react to the human body. I mean, I know I'm used to it. So we're gonna I can give it back to you later, okay? But I need to take it from you now, so sit down. We got to figure out a way of taking it back. Let me think here. Shook your hand, I gave it to you, so how can I take it back? I got an idea. Take your hands, put them like this. Yeah, shake. Watch what happens. Watching our fourth and final feature. At the count of three, eyes will definitely pop open. And each and every one of you are going to witness one of the best triple X-rated movies you've ever seen in your lifetime. They're doing things in this movie you've never experienced before, never might see for yourself. At the count of three, you're watching one of the best triple X-rated movies you've ever seen. Under absolutely no circumstance will anybody be able to physically touch each other on my stage in any way, shape, or form. Yeah, could be a different movie that way. Under no circumstance will anybody be able to physically touch themselves. Neither. Like I said, I've been doing this for too many years. You know what to say by now, okay? On the count of three, just watching the movie. One, two, three. Wow. At the count of three, this movie becomes 1,000 times more steamier. 1,000 times more explicit. One, two, three. Oh my god. Oh my god. Excuse me, sir. We're taking a survey at the theater this evening to our customers. We're curious whether or not we should be bringing back this type of movie for our customers here on the weekends. What do you think about that?
I think that being a nice, wholesome family place, this is definitely, you get like a Walt Disney movie playing in one theater, and you get something like this for the parents, and you got lots of kids, because the kids want to see the movie, and dad doesn't mind bringing the kids to the movies, got something like this watching in the movie theater.
I see, so you would like us to continue playing this type of movie for the adults on the weekends?
Oh, absolutely. I think it's, you know, it's just something that's got to be done. I mean, these girls, they got to make money too, you know. They probably have kids.
Excuse me, dear. We're just curious. We're taking a survey tonight at the theater whether or not we should be bringing back a separate movie here on the weekends again. What do you think about that?
Yep.
What do you think about that, sir? You think we should be bringing back a separate movie here on the weekends again?
I like it. A lot.
And a count of three, and a count of three only, I want you all to take a close-up of that movie. Because you're going to realize something. You're going to realize you didn't need to have the leading role in that movie. You'll recognize yourself on the screen. Past tense. Not future, not present, but the past. One, two, three. And now listen to the screen. And are you ever good at what you're doing out there? Wow, well, they can't, your camera went out, I guess, eh? Everybody, sit up straight in your chairs now. Under no circumstances will any of you fall. Everybody, slink deeply. Good, thank you for the gentleman is head touching now, eyes running tightly closed for you, so sitting up straight in your chair, head only erect. Sleepy figure. Head only erect, sir. Gentlemen is running touching. Now eyes running tightly closed for you, sir, sitting up straight in your chair, head only erect. The lady is running touching us sleepily. The gentleman is running touching now, eyes running tightly closed for you, sitting up straight in your chair, head only erect, eyes tightly closed. The gentleman is running touching now, now, and now. You three gentlemen, and only you three gentlemen. I want to invite you one to the center stage. You're not going to be an incredible singing group, gentlemen. You started your careers back in about 1962. You became a legend in the music industry because your names are none other than Diana Ross and the Supremes. The Supreme will be the gentleman assigned touching now. The Supreme, the gentleman assigned touching now. And none other than Diana Ross, our lead singer, the gentleman assigned touching now. Right by all three of you for the center stage. You're going to have so much sex up here. You're going to be teasing those gentlemen in the audience. Show them what they could never have, to a point, please, we are on national television. When you're ready for the bandage, you'll tell them you can bring on that rendition, number one, platinum hit of yours, Stop and Enable Love. You're going to have all the choreographed moves, you're going to have everything going for you, just incredible. Everybody else on my stage, big time fans of these three ladies, I'm really, really excited about being here tonight. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen of the audience, we got a real special treat for you tonight. These three individuals, they started back in the early 60s, and they started something called the Motown Sound. Yes, in Detroit, Michigan, Motor City. Would you like to welcome to center stage, reunited after many, many years now, Diana Ross and the Supremes. Incredible, ladies. Just look at all you ladies. Look, just mind just spreading yourself out here. Can I talk to you for a minute? Stay right in the lights here, back right up. You're looking fantastic here. What's brought you back together with a girl like this?
Well, just we felt like the world deserved us. You know, the world's been doing good. We'll give them a little treat.
Yeah! You know,
on. He knows.
It's incredible. You ladies, how do you keep yourselves in such wonderful shape, dear?
Well, you know, we work out a lot. Lots of aerobics. The stepmaster and shit, you know. You gotta keep it.
You look fantastic, still. You look great. Yeah. Pardon?
She does look good.
She looks fantastic. So do you, dear. You look great, too. You look great, too. Well, we'll get right out of the way here and let you spread yourselves out, ladies. At the count of three, hit it. One, two, three, hit it. Come on, we give it up for them. Or at least you make the more of them do great, I promise you. Come over here, sir. What? What the hell were you doing, sir?
I was wearing a wig.
You know, I don't mean to be rude to you, right, but it sort of looks like you were dressed in drag, sir.
Well, what I do in the privacy of my own home is nobody's business.
Well, I understand that, sir, privacy of your own home, but I mean, we're out here in the club tonight.
Oh, maybe guy goes out and has a few too many, but whatever.
Stand on, please. So what do you think of them, sir?
I like that one.
That one was really nice, like, eh? Hot stuff, eh? Huh?
Oh.
Well, yeah. Incredible, eh? What are you shaking your head about?
That is just great. I want that.
You want to see something real neat? I'll show you something. Well, watch this. I can maybe describe something to you. Everybody, mind sitting on straight in your chairs? Have you ever heard of, you know, the old expression? You know, yeah, like a hollow head. You know, your parents used to teach you. So you've heard that lot. What makes me think that you would have heard that lot? What's going to happen tonight? Everybody's in a hollow head, except you, of course. Pardon?
It's not true.
Pardon, sir?
I heard it last, but can I have one?
I ain't touching it. I just... What's going to happen is, see this fella here, and I'm going to shoot in this guy's ear. It's going to go right through because it's empty there. It's going to all the way through, and it hit the lady right at the end.
You did the shooting stuff before. There's a whole big mess up here. I don't know how you brought them all back together. Thank you. I don't want to be that busy. Don't be killing nobody.
Watch this. It's going to go right through everybody, right to the end. Boom! Oh, there must be something in this guy still. Oh, there we go. One, two, three. Boom! Ooh.
slow motion bullet.
So what do you think?
That's a hell of a slow bullet. You said you wasn't killing, they're not dead.
I don't know, let's check. Let's check this guy here.
Oh, I think he is.
Check over here. Martin, sir?
He's not dead.
Well, that's good. Guess what? Just you and me again. So you having a good time? You enjoying yourself over here? Pardon?
I think so.
You think so? What?
Why are you always keeping me awake and letting everybody else go to sleep?
Because I enjoy your company.
I enjoy your company too. Thank you, man.
You know, on the count of three, you're having the best time you've ever had in your life. One, two, three.
You know?
Oh, great!
So you ready to party? You want to party tonight?
You buy the drinks, baby. I want $25,000. We're going to get it!
So what's your favorite drink?
My favorite drink? Ryan Coke, man!
I just call it True Redneck Ryan Coke, right? Yeah. Ryan Coke kind of rocks. Toss her back. It's... Yeah. Another one, too. Another Ryan Coke. It's downer. What the hell? A double. Go for it, double.
You know what? You can
go ahead. Downer. Toss him back. Pretty smooth, eh?
That's some crown royal, man.
Another double. Go for it. Nobody becomes physically ill on my stage. So, what?
You have one with me, buddy?
You know, you like doing shooters?
Oh, sure.
You know what my favorite shooter is? There. Tequila.
I need some salt.
Yeah, salt. Just put in your... Oh, sorry, other hand. Oh, sorry, didn't mean... Lime, too? Yeah, there we go. Count three, go for it. Lick, suck, and shoot, right? Is that what they call? Okay, one, two, three, go for it. You know, I got another one here. This one you probably never tried. Maybe you have. I did years ago, but I found some of this stuff. Here's a shooter here. 190 proof Everclear. Give her a shot. Yeah, is it one of you, Kevin? Go for it. Toss her back. What the hell? Go for it. It's a weekend. This is... at the count of three, and only at the count of three, all of your eyes and knee bubble and once again, these house come on regular basis. Ladies and gentlemen, I reached a portion of the performance you're placing it anyway. The gentleman is head ain't touching now, and only the gentleman is head ain't touching. So if you can't throw your eyes on deep, Bob, open. Everybody else on my stage, you will remain sleeping very, very deeply. Only the gentleman is head ain't touching now. Eyes on deep, Bob, open. You can return to your seat or area in the audience. This music that is indeed playing will no longer affect you as you return to your seat in the audience. And so what you're going to become is one of my worst nightmares. You can become the legendary heckler, the guy that's always in the audience, got the big mouth of the whole place, always trying to give the entertainer the bad time. The very moment I take my hand off your forehead and count to three, you will return to the audience. The very moment you sit down.